How to bring up a lagging muscle group or a lagging body part. I'm going to take the example of chest in this video because somebody came to me recently with that question saying, I'm training hard, I'm benching good, everything's good, but I just don't seem to be built. I can't seem to build this chest. Shoulders are getting pumped, triceps are getting pumped, my back's even working while I'm doing bench press. But I just can't get the chest to grow. Shall I do flies? Shall I do cables? Shall I do this? Shall I do that? Shall I use the cuffs? Absolutely not. Do not use. I was going to swear there again. I need to learn more words. That's what it is. I need to stop swearing. But I didn't swear. I stopped myself. Do not use cuffs and bands and all this kind of stuff. Let me explain why. Or don't substitute that for a bench press, and I'll explain why. So when you are training the chest, you need a lot of weight to build a chest. Heavy weights is what's going to build your chest. You need that. That is 100% fact. The more heavy weights you use, that is what's going to build. Remember the Big Ten video? If you haven't seen it, go and watch it. Can I link it here? I don't know if I can. I can't. Just type it in, Big Ten, it'll come up. When you're lifting weight, so you're trying to grow a muscle group, you want to do the most effective exercise for that. It's always got to start with the most things that you, the two exercises that you can lift the most weight on. Bench press, incline bench press, or incline incline dumbbells or flat dumbbells. Those are the four exercises. Your whole workout, your 80 to 90% of your workout, all the energy wants to be expended right there. Then you can faff around with the accessories like dips and cable flies. That's all I recommend. So how do you do it then? How is it possible in order to grow a chest? If the guy can't feel it every time he's training, his shoulders and triceps are taking over, here is the hack. This doesn't work on every single body part, but I'm going to tell you what it does work, how to do it for chest. I keep stuttering today because I don't want to swear. What you want to do is you want to do press-ups. Standard, box standard prison press-ups. We all know how they work. Standard hands shoulder width apart or a slight bit wider, all the way down. Get your chest to either touch the floor or very close from the floor. Now, if you are benching and you are a very strong guy, you should be able to knock out at least 50 press-ups. In fact, here's a challenge for some guys, and I want you to be honest in the comments down below. I will tell you mine. In fact, do you know what? I'm not going to tell you mine. I want you to guess. How many press-ups do you think I can do in a row non-stop? The rule is, this is the rule, your feet and your hands cannot leave the floor. You can rest at the top, you can rest at the bottom position, but as long as your chest doesn't touch the floor, you can rest as long as you want. How many press-ups do you think I can do in one go with no rest? Sorry, you can rest, but without stopping. I want to see how many you can do. And I'm telling you one thing now, you probably sit there and think, oh, I bet I can do 100. Bro, let me tell you one thing. If you can do 50 press-ups in a row, non-stop, full-on press-ups, proper press-ups. I'm going to show them in another video what press-ups are. You're kind of good. If you can do 70, you're in the top range. I've seen some CrossFitters. I've seen videos of CrossFitters, and they literally get to like 80 mark, and 80 is tough. 90 is elite level. And if you can do 100, you are the cream of the crop when it comes to press-ups. But here's what you want to do. Anyway, that's another video, but here's what you want to do for a weak lagging chest. I want you to do 100 press-ups every single day for 30 days. You're going to think, how is that possible? Quite easy. All you need to do is break it up into a couple of sets. So you just do 10 sets of 10. Very easy. Do a set of 10. 10 should be a walk in the park. If you're a strong guy, 10 should be a walk in the park. Bang out 10. If you can't bang out 10 and it's difficult, do it on your knees. You know, I know some of you guys are pretty weak. Do it on your knees. But bang out 10. 10 sets of 10. Half a minute rest in between each set. Shouldn't really take you more than 10-15 minutes to complete. 10 sets of 10, easy. Next day, try 5 sets of 20. Day after, if you're really, you know, getting the hang of it, 3 sets of 33 or and then 134, work it out. You know what I mean? So just figure it out. Or what you could do is bang out as many as you can. So you might bang out 50 and then go back down again and start with 51, 52, 53. You know what I'm trying to say. So it doesn't matter how many sets it takes. Try and fatigue yourself a little bit, and you want to do this every single day for 30 days. Let me tell you what it does. Most people would think that's overtraining. It's actually not overtraining, I'll tell you why. Because you're only using your body weight. You're not adding any extra weight to this. It's body weight only. Eventually, after day 4, day 5, your body will get used to this. It'll become accustomed to it. It won't fatigue as much. You will still get the pump. And what we're trying to do here in 30 days is we're trying to build a mind-muscle connection. There's something called a, is it a neurological response, or is it, I don't know what it is. Neurological, I'm not even trying to get technical over here. But the point I'm trying to say is we're trying to build the connection from here to here. So that after a month, I mean, you're still training chest as normal. So for example, in that month, if you're training chest four times a month, you still train chest normal. That on that chest workout day, do the press-ups after the session or at night. Don't do them in the morning. Make sure in that day we're training chest, you're fresh to train chest. After you doing one whole month of training chest, of doing press-ups every single day and doing about four sessions of chest in that month, what will happen is you will build up this mind-muscle connection that you have where you can just do the press-ups. Sorry, you can do the bench press and it will feel as if you're doing the press-ups. But the difference with the bench press is you can add a hell of a lot more weight. And when you've got that mind-muscle connection with any body part, if you have a mind-muscle connection with any body part, that is how a body part grows. And one other thing as well, do not deliberately go slow. By any means, do not try to go slow. When anything that you're doing in your training, you want to be explosive in these press-ups. So when these press-ups, when you're doing these press-ups, you want to be banging them out. Bam, bam, bam. As fast as possible. The key is speed over here. You're going to be banging these out non-step. Don't go slow just for the sake of it. Do not go slow because that's not what we're doing. Because when we start going slow, what happens? Our body starts to compensate. Elbows, shoulders, back. Your ass starts to dip a little bit. Your front delts take over. We're not doing that. This is front chest is locked. Once it's locked, it's pump. And we're just pumping. I can't demonstrate right now on the table. I'll do the demonstration in another video. 100 press-ups. Every single day for 30 days, that's 3,000 press-ups. My maths is still pretty good. 3,000 press-ups in the month, plus four, maybe five, maybe six chest workouts, depending on how many times a week you train chest. I train chest personally just once, possibly twice, depending on my rotation. I have a four-day split. And that is how you train. And that is how you bring up a lagging body part. So I explained it there for chest. Now, it doesn't work for every single muscle group. You have to be very smart with what you're doing it. Chest is an easy one because you can do a bodyweight exercise. If you're struggling on squats, you're struggling on quads, do some lunges every morning, 100 lunges, 100 squats, body weight only. And when it comes to pull-ups, if you're a real man, now this is a tough challenge. I'm not going to say this is easy. This is very tough. If you can do 100 pull-ups on the bar every single morning, that is tough. That is how you build a back. I actually train back very mediocre at the minute because I'm doing back every single day by doing pull-ups because pull-ups is tough. Pull-ups aren't like press-ups. Pull-ups are actually really hard. But try and, you know what? Start with 50 a day. Start by doing 50 pull-ups a day. You'll definitely build a back just doing that. With pull-ups, you're not just building a mind-muscle connection. You're actually building the muscle. With chest press-ups, a little different. You might not build a lot of chest, but you're building the mind-muscle connection. But with pull-ups, I can almost guarantee you, you're not only building the mind-muscle connection, you are building pure, solid, dense muscle that is going to stay with you forever. I can almost guarantee you that. So what else have we got? Shoulders. Now for shoulders is a tricky one. I'll tell you why it doesn't work for shoulders. Shoulders, you can easily injure. I mean, if you look at the range of motion the shoulders can go in, all sorts, yeah? Way too dangerous to just go into this plane of motion for side delts every single day. Way too much wear and tear on your delts. Do not doing it because you're training your delts. Remember, guys, when you're doing chest, when you're doing shoulders, when you're doing back, and when you're doing legs, when you're squatting, the bar is on your back. It's over here. You're using everything to hold the bar. All this, you know, it's very stable. So there's not a day that goes by where you're not training your shoulders anyway. Now, there is another technique I use. I'll explain in another video on how to double up on your shoulder workout. I'll explain how to do that another day. But right now, if you have any lagging body parts, single-jointed exercises, scrap that. I'm not going to edit it out. Not single-jointed exercise, body-weighted exercise is what I'm trying to say. Anything that you can do body-weighted exercise on and get away with by not fatiguing yourself, you can do it every single day for 30 days. Give it a go, guys. Hopefully, this video gave you guys some value. Please subscribe, like, and comment down below.